Hello friends, in this video we will discuss the water jug problem of artificial intelligence and we will develop the Prolog code for the same. So first let us understand what is the water jug problem. The water jug problem says that we have two jugs of different capacities of 4 liter and 3 liter and using these two jugs we want to measure 2 liters of water. Now, on any of the jugs, there are no markings of how much water is there in the jug. There are no marks on the or labels on the jugs. And we just know by size that one of the jugs is 4 liters and the other is the 3 liters. Now, how do we measure the 2 liters of water? Now, as we know, there is a system in artificial intelligence that a problem can be solved by developing its production system. So here also we have a set of rules and based on those rules we are going to solve this problem. So the formal description of the problem is that we have to define the state space that contains the all possible configurations. Then we have to specify one or more states within that state space which will be called as the initial state. Then we have to define the goal state. And we have to define the set of rules that will describe the actions that will be taken or the operations that will be performed in order to reach the solution. So here we are with the formal description. The state space will describe any of the states as XY, where X stands for the 4 liter jug and Y stands for the 3 liter jug. Now the X can take any value of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 because it is a 4 liter jug. It can be empty which is identified by 0 or it can be full which is identified by 4. Similarly the Y, it is a 3 liters or a 3 gallon jug and it is represented 0 means empty and 3 means it is full. The start state is 0, 0, that is both the jugs are empty and the goal state is 2, 0. Which means there is 2 liters of water in the 4 liter jug. Now coming to the production rules, which is a very important part of any AI problem. So in the production rules, we have a set of 12 rules and we have to convert these rules into the Prolog coding in order to develop a solution for the given problem. So what are the rules? It says that given the XY, if the 4 gallon jug has less than 4 liters of water, then fill the 4 gallon jug. If the 3 gallon jug has less than 3 liters of water, then fill the 3 liter jug. Then if the amount of water in the 4 liters is more than 0, then you pour some water out of the 4 liter jug. If there is more water, then the 3 liter jug is not empty, then pour some water out of the 3 liter jug. Then if the 4 liter jug has water more than 0, that means it is not empty, then you empty the 4 liter jug. So this is the next state, this is the goal, this is the current state, that is when you enter the function fill. This is the state, this is the condition which should be satisfied and when you leave the function fill, then this will be the output state of your function. Then if the 3 liters jug has more than empty water, then you pour the water of the 3 liter jug on the ground. Now if the total water in the X plus Y jug is more than equal to 4, in that case, pour some water out of the 4 liter jug into the, pour some water out of the 3 liter jug into the 4 liter jug. And if the total water is more than equal to 3, then pour the water from the 3 liter jug into the, 4 liter jug into the 3 liter jug. And if the total amount of water is less than equal to 4, then you pour all the water from the 3 liter jug into the 4 liter jug. Then if the total amount of water in both the jugs is less than 3 and the 4 liter jug is empty, then you pour all the water from the 4 liter jug into the 3 liter jug. Sorry, here it is X is more than 0, that is it is not empty. Then 0, 2 is there, then you pour the 2 liters of water from the 3 gallon jug into the 4 gallon and if you reach 2, whatever is the water contained in the 3-liter jug, that means this is your goal state. And you empty the 2 liters of water on the ground. So, these are the rules. This is the entering state and this is the next state which you will reach. And we have to implement this in Prolog in order to get the final solution. Now, let us look at the two solutions that we can reach using these rules. And then we will look at the Prolog code. So, this is the state space that we have. Initially, we have 0, 0. We have two choices. Either you fill the 4-liter jug or the 3-liter jug. Suppose we fill the 3-liter jug. Now again we have multiple choices. So in the from 3-liter jug, then you fill the 3-liter and 4-liter both the jugs by pouring the water from the 3-liter into 4-liter, and then you have the choice of pouring some water from the 3-liter into 4-liter till the 4-liter is full, and finally you will get the 0-2 and then 2-0. So, this set of states can be reached using the following rules. Initially, both the jugs are empty. Then you fill the 3-liter jug. Then you pour this water into the 4-liter jug. Then you again fill the 3-liter jug. Now you have 3-3 water in both. Now you pour some water from the 3-liter into the 4-liter. So, 4 liters is full and you have 2 liters of water in the 3-liter jug. And then just some shuffling is required in order to reach the goal state. Then, suppose you fill the 4-liter jug instead of the 3-liter jug. In that case, again we have a solution. And what is the solution? That you pour some water from the 4-liter jug into the 3-liter till it is full. You have 1 liter of water left. Now, what you do? You pour that 1 liter into the 3-liter jug and then you fill the 4-liter jug once again. And then you pour the water from the 4-liter into the 3-liter. So, 2 liters of water will be left in the 4-gallon jug. And as we can see here, the same solution written here. Initially, both the jugs are empty. Then you fill the 4-liter jug. Then you pour the water into the 3-liter from the 4-liter jug. Then you pour this water of 3 liters on the ground. Then you pour the 1 liter into the 3-liter jug. Then you fill the 4-liter jug again and then pour the water into the 3-liter. So, 3 liters will contain full 3 liters. And there is 2 liters of water in the 4-gallon jug. Now, let us look at the Prolog code in order to get the solution. So, we have this first function call is there, which we will call in order to implement this coding. So, this is fill x, y dot. What this will do is when we will on the command prompt, when we will write fill with some values of x and y, this will make a call to the respective functions and then the actual coding will start. Then as you can see here, if there is 2 liters of water in the 4 liter jug, then we will say goal state is reached. If x and y water is there, x is 0 and y is less than 1, then we will fill the 4 liter jug. And all the rules which we have discussed previously on the previous slides, those rules are implemented here. As you can see here, the same rules are implemented here. And this will help us in getting the solution. So, as you can see, all the 12 rules have been implemented. And the solution, as you can see here, when I say fill 0,3 on the command prompt of Prolog, then it will show me all the steps that are to be performed in order to reach the goal state. And similarly, when I say fill 4,0, then it will perform all the steps to reach the final state. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my channel, please subscribe to it and please recommend my channel to your friends. Thank you very much.